Excuse me. My apologies. Good afternoon, everybody. Keith here. Hoping everybody's having a good day, enjoying life, living life, loving life. Want to get on today, talk about some things, particularly the flags. While reviewing videos on this Delete Laws site with Chili DeCastro and his fight with Ironton Police Department and all the different lawsuits he's got going on, and him claiming he's going to move from California to Ironton, Ohio, and establish his residency there, and this and that, and how you get there by all these paved roads and sidewalks and flat stones on the ground. We're going to talk about them. We're going to talk about flags. And first off and foremost, I'd like everybody to know that I don't stand under any flag. I don't like none of them. My standing is established on the ground, not on flags. So we're going to talk about the definition of flags, but we're going to wait till the end because I want everybody to comprehend that when you see a flag, it is an advertisement. That's it. It is nothing more than a commercial advertisement. So let's talk about advertisement real quick and real simple. It's an adversarial enticement. Advertisement. They are inviting you into an adversarial form of paperwork known as Battle of the Forms. If you're already at peace and you don't want to have a fight, you don't want to battle things, and you don't want to have to do this and that, then you refuse their Battle of the Forms by refusing their advertisement. Now, what happens in most countries today in modern times, everybody goes through a birth registration and they're indoctrinated to stand in class in school while they're being indoctrinated into a military force. I pledge allegiance, excuse me, I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And God damn it, I'm a good American and I support the blue line. Fucking bunch of babbling idiots. Excuse me if that hurts. Because again, I don't give a fucking rat's ass if you're in the military. See, I'm one of the very few people that has his own comprehension and doesn't depend on everybody else to comprehend and think for me. It's called thinking. You should try it sometime. See, when we're born into this indoctrination system and everybody grows up making that pledge of allegiance while mom and dad are trying to teach them how to keep their pledge with the Lord our Father, which art in heaven, by following his son's ways, his son's parables, and knowing how to comprehend them. He spoke in parables for a reason, because it takes thinking. See, today's modern English is a convenience. And they use it as an advertisement by inducing you through the public education system to believe that you understand English. I don't understand English. I understand the word of our Father, which art in heaven, which is written on my heart. And I use the scriptures as my holy writs to base that foundation because that's what the world believes in. See, the world believes in original scriptures. Well, yet, as we live today in these modern times, we're being indoctrinated into understanding legislated words for commercial purposes only. It's for protecting the commercial copyrights and patents and trademarks of original works. And here we have the entire world believing that it depends on somebody else, what somebody else says. Because they don't know how to understand or comprehend the origination that's in your heart. The true artist is that which lies here. So, in this Chile de Castro, claiming that he's going to go establish residency in Ohio. Okay, he's under the United States flag without a border. And the United States flag with the gold fringe border. And now he's going to disclaim the California flag and move over to Ohio and claim the Ohio flag. Now, is this guy confused or what? The way I see it, it's not just him. But it goes to the people that are on these YouTube channels trying to prove his point of law that the blue flag is not a desecration of the American flag, which they're right. They're right. The blue line flag is not a desecration of the American flag. The blue line flag is in and of itself a creation of one man who followed up from the concept of the thin blue line, which was coincidentally established way back in 1871. This isn't a modern era thing, folks. It's just a modern era, more prolific expression of that which was originated clear back 151 years ago. See, that thin blue line incorporates the capacity of the citizenry on the top part and the police standing for the citizenry on the top part. And the thin blue line is the thing that's keeping the citizenry separate from the criminal activities below the thin blue line. So let's talk about that. Again, if you're paying homage to that flag and its citizenry, what is the thin blue line and the citizenry of that thin blue line determination there? Is that just the citizenry of the police departments? Or does it include perhaps the citizenry of the United States without the border, the United States with the gold fringe border, or just the state you're in? Or is it equality of law among all of the states? See, I think a lot of people are confused about all of this and raising all these flags. See, we here at the Keith Orland Little Faith-Based Union understand Jeremiah 1 verse 5 says, He knew us before He formed us in the belly, before we were cast from the womb. He sanctified us. He ordained us as prophets unto the nations. Not as a part of the nation, because we're not supposed to profit the word of the nations. We're supposed to profit His word unto the nations, whose profit is in a commercial aspect only. Even their churches who profess to be profiting the word of God are in fact commercial entities profiting from the very fact of being a non-profit organization, wherein they get to make tax collections. What flag do they fly? What flag do the churches fly? See, before all this came about, churches didn't fly a flag, did they? It was the empire that raises flags. And those flags are men of sovereignty. And those flags back then had a heraldry. The heraldry was the talents that were brought forth as specialties in that nation. So one nation who might herald the wheat leaves might know another nation by the heralding of fig leaves. Hey, there's somebody we can trade our wheat for oil. It still, even then, was an advertisement. So when we think about this, and we think about the wants and desires, it tells us in the Bible we're not supposed to want. Yet everybody thinks they need to go to these stores to get what they need. because they don't have what they want. Because they're depending on what they want from everybody else by living on flags. And yes, I said living on flags. So let's talk about flags. Let's talk about flags. Everybody knows I always like my King James Version of the Bible best. So let's take a look at it. This is King James Dictionary definition of flag. And generally, they will get their dictionary definitions from Webster's American Dictionary of the English Language from 1828. So we see this is antecedent, prior to the blue line. Okay? Prior to the thin blue line, which was prior to the thin blue line flag. So let me show you guys the ignorance of flying flags and what its true advertisement is. Because when they fly flags, they fly flags because they suffer. They fly flags because they are losing their spiritual aspect. They fly flags because they live on flags. They fly flags because living on flags, they cover up the earth that gives them everything they could need. So they cover up their needs with flags. Let's take a look. Flag as a verb. See, flaccid. You know, when they talk about the men's penis and it being flaccid, it's limp. Just like a limp-wristed bitch. It means to hang loose without stiffness, to bend down as flexible bodies, to be loose and yielding as the flagging sails, to grow spiritless or dejected, to droop, to grow languid as the spirit's flag, to grow weak, to lose vigor as the strength flags, to become dull or languid. The pleasure of the town begin to flag, to let fall into feebleness, to suffer to drop as to flag the wings, a flat stone or pavement of flat stones. What is a ledge? A flat stone slab covering a grave. You come into life believing in a flag. And when you go out, you are flagged. So your spirit cannot come back up out of that ground. So, we want to sit there and argue about the American flag, gold fringe flag, or the blue line flag, or any other flag. Particularly like maybe the Joint Chiefs of Staff. When, remember, I was talking about DeCastro moving from California to Ohio, and he's going to disclaim the California flag and claim the Ohio flag. He's still under the Joint Chiefs of Staff in that operation of five different flags around the world. All under the law of flags, instituted through the law of nations, otherwise known as the law, principles of the laws of nature. So he's proving by his own principles and his own nature that he himself is nothing but a lost spirit, bent and weak. Bent and weak. Bent and weak. If you can't bring the word of God, you are already proven you are weak by falling suffering to the word of English. Which, by the way, for those that are curious, the thin blue line started in Great Britain. Like I said, in 1871, as the thin red line. So you have been deceived all the way through and through, you fucking weak flags. See, in and of professing a flag, you yourself prove you are a flag. Seems kind of idiotic and babblish to me. And please, be sure to share this video. Because I make a call out not just to DeCastro, not just to Chili DeCastro, not just to the Ironton police, not just to the Ironton, the county sheriff, what's his name, Jeffrey Lawless, the county sheriff of that area, not just the president of the United States, but everybody. Every living soul, take heed, and I urge you to try to rebut it. I don't care how much knowledge you think you have, because if you truly have that knowledge, you won't rebut it, because you know it's true. No man has jurisdiction over another man, period, whether it be by that false advertisement or not. And yes, I said the United States flag, any flag, is a false advertisement. I urge you to rebut it. Because it is certainly deceptive. Unless you know what is true. And to pose in your public education system that you need to pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, again, without defining the term flag, you prove deception. So until any education system around this world gets back to the original origination of the words, which means scriptures, whether it be the King James Version of the Bible in Christianity and Catholicism or Buddhism, Muslim, whatever, whatever spiritual scriptures you follow, that's what your education system should be following. That's what proves that their flag is a false advertisement. Because, see, if it's spiritual, it does not flag. He commanded, and it was done. He spake, and it stood fast. So let's talk about this personal jurisdiction, and a notice I want to put out to every living soul on this planet in regards to a public trust and your fiduciary capacities as contracted under those flags. You too have been deceived. And I don't give a fuck what flag you come under. I don't give a fuck how many armies you want to bring. I don't give a fuck about none of it. And for those that want to sit there and dismiss me because of my swearing, saying that's not scriptural, the fuck it ain't. See, when they talk about blasphemy of the word of God, using the word of God in vain by swearing, they're talking about using the word of God in your own advertisements. See, I'm not advertising the commercial aspect. I'm telling the commercial aspect, it can go fuck itself. No matter who wants to present it. See, we here at Keith Orland Little Faith-Based Union, we're just like him. We are a respecter of no persons. So we don't give a fuck about your person. We don't give a fuck about the Fourth Amendment. We don't give a fuck about the Fifth Amendment. We don't give a fuck about the Seventh Amendment and that measly little $20. The fuck is $20? So let's talk about this notice. And again, this is out to every man, woman, and child, living soul that thinks they have control over another man living, or another man's living soul, period. So, for Ironton Police, all you corrupt bitches being exposed everywhere, not just the Ironton Police, everybody under the blue line, everybody under the United States flag, everybody under their Joint Chiefs of Staff, every nation around this world. Pay attention. See, this is my website. And this is on my general notices page. You'll see I've got an international notice to PayPal that I just did not too long ago. An email notice to PayPal and an email notice to IRS. This was my first lines of communication in the private. Matthew 18, verses 15. They didn't want to do it. So I went to the next step. I went public. I brought my second witness. Now PayPal has amended the agreement. Because buyer's terms and conditions supersede everything else according to this purchase agreement. Noting, faith-based union. It's Keith Thornton Little, faith-based union making this. And these are the additional terms in acceptance or confirmation, 2-207 UCC. They want to use that. This is what this is referring to. Notice it says reference. Then I let them know that reference is under the Global Postal Trust. Notices and opinions held to be true as taken note of the following articles within the public domain and reported here are open for improvement and clarifications for reason of variances. All complaints, concerns, comments, or compliments welcome via WordWizard at WordWiseWarrior.art. Free communication, folks. That is not a .com extension. Freely communicating. Absolutely no presumptions allowed. And then I've got my 12 presumptions beating their 12, my 12 little things here, defeating their 12 presumptions of the Roman court. And y'all can come look at this. And then we go to ex parte communications. That's that private communication, non-commercial. Guess where it's at? Emergency Banking Act. Federal Reserve Act has no authority because it's a public communication, not a private communication. Let's get that out in the open real quick. Who regulates the congressional budget? Did you guys know the Postal Congress? The International Postal Congress regulates the congressional budget of every nation on the planet that are involved in that UN Charter Agreement. Charter, the flag agreement, the commission and its offices. This is the Postal Commission, Postal Regulatory Commission. My, under public records of personnel. Everybody under this code is actually, in fact, working as a postal officer by everything that you post to the record. That's their record. It's all there, folks. All you got to do is educate yourself. Absolutely no consent to vaccinations. You can read that one. That's talking about the Libra Code, Law of Nations, and this and that. Contracts on the international sale of goods. See, we're not here. And particularly the doctor's Hippocratic Oath to Apollo and Asclepius and Hygieia and Panacea and all the gods and goddesses as my witnesses. They take a Hippocratic oath to Greek mythology, folks, and then proclaim some kind of vaccination opinions through the CDC and the World Health Forums. Why are you believing this fucked up shit? Got my statement of separation. Noticing the espionage laws and the public money and property records. Gathering, transmitting, or losing defense information. It's all there. So here we go. Notice to all public servants and public accommodators. I come to you in peace with knowledge, in forbearance of your duties. It would be to your own advantage to learn the reality of personal jurisdiction. I myself have knowledge that you may in fact be involved with what would technically be evidenced in statutes and codes as kidnapping. I will fix this so the text is larger. My apologies. I'm still building my site. I merely wish to displace the confusion with knowledge. This is not my full notice. Let me get my full notice, folks. There we go. Let's do it here. Like I said, I'm still developing my page. And so, we come to you in peace with knowledge and forbearance of your duties. It would be to your own advantage to learn the reality of personal jurisdiction, as I myself have knowledge that you may in fact be involved in what would technically be evidenced in statutes and codes as kidnapping. We know these are serious allegations and hope that they are not taken as a threat, as that is not our intent. We merely wish to displace the confusion with knowledge, a disposition. You go to court and they have that preliminary hearing. It's a disposition hearing. They're trying to find out who's going to flag. That flag's already waved. Stand strong. So then we go on to the next part. It says, first, there are basically only two presumptuous jurisdictions of which you practice. And those are civil and criminal. When one looks at the rules for your courts, they distinctly express one form of action, civil. One form of action, civil. Civil action with criminal procedures. This places an inconsistency in the actual enforcement to begin with, considering that those would be based upon subject matter first. So if there's one form of action, and it's civil, the subject matter is always civil. The subject matter is always going to be contracts. Always. Period. No ifs, ands, or buts. Again, I ask any legal scholar to rebut the order of the words that I have marshaled. Excuse me, the marshaling of the words I have placed. Second, but foremost, is the fact that no one can just have personal jurisdiction because of the stated subject matter. See, it clearly states in your codes, United States Code, to which all states ceded statutory jurisdiction through contract form, see 48 CFR 52.212-5, wherein it states, I succinctly quote, contract terms and conditions required to implement statutes or executive orders, hyphen, commercial goods or services. That personal jurisdiction of the defendant can only be had by one's voluntary appearance, as quoted from LII Wex Cornell Westlaw site online international forum, part of the Consortium International Library, public domain. It is open and is not rebutted and stands as is, and it states, obtaining personal jurisdiction, typically for a court, typographically, the type, what type of a court is distinguished by the flag that it flies. Okay? So typically in admiralty, to have personal jurisdiction over a defendant, the plaintiff needs to serve the defendant in the state in which the court sits, proving that admiralty sits in the court states as well. We are talking about the International Forum on a Maritime Contract in all courts. And the defendant needs to voluntarily appear in court. You guys read that? And the defendant. So they have to serve the defendant in the state in which the court sits. Now, if the court sits in a state of advertisement under an admiralty flag, and I don't, because I don't fly any flags, then they have not served a defendant. And the defendant needs to voluntarily appear in court. You guys know what a defendant is? A call out to all English majors around this world. Rebut, please. As fend is the root being a verb, they have obliterated the original form of a verb, meaning fend off, meaning fight off, or protect even. And changed it by adding a prefix, changing it to defend, meaning take away the protection. And the suffix of ant being a transitive of the verb, transitioning it from a verb to a noun. What type of a noun is defendant? What type of a noun is a defendant? All English scholars around the world, please rebut. Defendant is what is known as an abstract noun. Please think, people, they abstracted the information from one place and converted it to a different type of information in another place. Defendant is an abstract noun, being such as a third-person noun, meaning a total fiction, as in Tom Sawyer, a character written in ink within the pages of a book that were hand-authored by a man who titled the authorization under a name, Mark Twain, who was in fact named Samuel Clemens by someone else and not by himself. So he used Samuel Clemens as the first person and then Mark Twain as the second person, and thereby stepping into trustee capacity as calling himself Mark Twain. Where does that fiction exist in the public record as a statistic? It doesn't. See, the defendant is a third-person abstract noun, and it is a creation of Mark Twain, who is itself a creation of Samuel Clemens, and not the Samuel Clemens that was created by Mom and Dad. It was Samuel Clemens' own creation, thereby providing a trust without need of a trustee, simply by stepping into a position of trust without any proper, what they call, trust assignments. It's presumed already by form. Know how to marshal the words. Let's go on to the next one. Federal Rules of Civil Procedure Rule 4K describes whether a state's courts would have authority to adjudicate a claim as it relates to personal jurisdiction. Describes whether a state's courts would. See, it's telling you right now they do not have the authority to do so yet. It's a description of whether a state court would have authority. And if you don't present a third person fiction in their courts and can't, then you can't be the defendant by merely knowing the defendant is a third person character that somebody else wrote. I don't have that person. That person belongs to my mom and dad as they created it. They're the ones that made the agreement with the United States under the flag. Now, granted, I was indoctrinated into a system, but I have thrown off the flag. I have thrown off the government. I have thrown off every shred of government and only operate under a doctrine of necessity of using various instrumentalities as a basic need. That is it. Take heed, all public servants. So we see, no matter what jurisdiction is stated as subject matter, and without regard to personal jurisdiction, the basis of state court authority rests with territorial jurisdiction, which must be clarified and not assumed. It must be clarified and not presumed. You are all assuming that the jurisdiction applies to you because you have been indoctrinated. Now, this is to prevent them. I'm speaking to these public servants. It's to prevent you from trading with the enemy, as noted in Trading with the Enemy Act in regards to judicial activities or making any erroneous entries into the ledger, the record, that flat flag that lays on a flat surface that you inscribe with your bullshit. Forcing people to attend court through threats of arrest or illicit warrants for a volunteer participant. Defendant needs to voluntarily appear in court, and if the defendant is a third person abstract noun, that is total fiction, it cannot voluntarily appear in court. It must be presented or re-presented. Got it? The third person abstract noun known as a defendant cannot. And again, I ask all English majors, all legal scholars, everybody that thinks they got the kahunas to try to rebut this simple fact around the world, please do so. And I remind you people, I graduated high school. That's it. I was indoctrinated pleasantly. It wasn't until I graduated high school or shortly therefore before it that I got involved with the criminal side, the bottom side of that thin blue line. And I assure you that blue line is
very fucking thin. Because when it comes down to the statistics, people, that thin blue line is so thin in the statistical population record that if the people really wanted to stand up and say, fuck it, enough is enough, we ain't paying attention to your flag or that flag or that flag or that flag, just like I am, but they don't get it through their peaceful hearts like I do, and they start bringing weapons to the table, I guarantee you, those type of people will slaughter you. I'm not going to be involved in it. I don't carry arms in that sense. I do not have firearms. I'm not part of the Militia Act, otherwise known as a dick. I refuse to be a dick. I don't have any records. I don't keep ledgers. I don't keep flags. For a volunteer participant would be against the duty of knowledge. You now have knowledge that the defendant is a third person abstract noun that is a total fiction and cannot possibly appear in court voluntarily. It must be presented or represented in court by another voluntarily doing so. An act, a voluntary act. The defendant itself, as merely ink and paper, cannot act. Okay? Remember, you all have duty to one another and to God in your capacity of public servants and trust in armed conflicts of war. Armed conflicts of public war. This is Libra Code. I urge everybody to read this page. On my site, we are hoping to get a positive response as we intend no harm, but rather to help correct things that are terribly wrong with the minds and hearts of man these days. We ask that all of you seriously consider the circumstances for which one is placing their physical control over another and only do so as a matter of peace and love and not for a paycheck. See, that thin blue line, like I said, was started by one man who corporatized it and started selling it as his support for police enforcement. That's all it is. And he did his research and created a thin blue line flag. But in that research, he couldn't provide a thin blue line flag like the Brits did because the American flag would convolute that, and he wouldn't be able to express the thin red line. So he'd issue forth a blue line regarding blue uniforms, blue coats, and red coats. See how the Civil War is still being acted out? Do you not see the deception? We cannot grant such personal jurisdiction, for we have no such person. We, here at the Keith Orland Little FBU, oops, cannot grant such personal jurisdiction, for we have no such persons. And then, of course, it says, reverently, Chaplain Keith. I use chaplain, and I'll explain why. Etymology of chaplain goes to little cloak. The chaplain is the one that holds his church in his cathedral. The cathedral would be the structure that protects him from Mother Earth's natural elements in his chapel, which contains those Mother Nature's elements. So while in his chapel, his cathedral, his cloak, under his cloak, under the big cloak, I operate as the little cloak in my own cathedral, as my own chaplain, spreading his word, a prophet unto the nations, as I said, Jeremiah 1 verse 5 in the 1611 King James Version of the Bible, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. Before thou wast cast from the womb, I sanctified thee. I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. And this is what tells me in my heart, not to subject myself, not to become weak spiritually and fall under the pledge allegiance of a flag of any kind, of any nation or any state or any school or any education. Because what is instilled in my heart says that he commanded and it was done. It's already done. I don't need to do those such things. Those are adding unto and taking away from the word of God. And I can't do that but in my heart. I urge everybody. To learn and comprehend again. If you look through my videos from 6 years ago, you'll see how I operated in the courts and how I... when I was not in those courts and I was starting out doing these videos, it was very plain and simple. It was in an educational capacity, as I'm trying to get back to now. But as time went on, you could see my anger and resentments and everything started coming out more and more. The more I researched, the angrier I got. And in that, I was standing by my profession that I was going to sue these guys and I was going to take them to hell and back, and they were going to lose everything they owned. And that's what this Chile de Castro is trying to profess. And you can't do that. You will lose. That is a losing environment. They are advertising you into a battle of the forms, and you have already subjected yourself to losing your own form of spirituality, by placing the words, the living breath of God that made man a living soul, and you're taking that living soul away and placing them back in the words of man on paper. You can't do that. If you're going to do that, you got to do it in the right sense and let them know what you truly hold in your heart by using those words. And again, like I said, I'm not going to be one of the ones that's going to come against that blue line slaughtering them, because I don't own any weapons. My only weapon is my word to defeat one's opponent without fighting is of supreme excellence. And therefore, I am the author. I am Mark Twain, not my mom and dad, who by presumption the state takes care of all the documentation and protects their rights because they're no longer around. So they have to protect my mom and dad's rights. See, we're not talking about my mom and dad's rights anymore. We're not talking about the rights that they instituted on that record. Now, you have to protect that record according to their rights. See, we're not talking about that record anymore. That record is false, and I can prove it, because it's not my record, and you're holding it against me as if though you're trying to protect those rights, and I haven't accepted the proper inheritance. I have. I've shed off that last name. Like I said, I spent all my life trying to figure out how to put my real family back together. And then I found out, dejected and disheartened, that I couldn't. So I had to step on to the next thing. I had to create my own family. And then I went through the struggle of trying to keep that family together, and that was torn apart. And then after all that, my own family, in my continued research and continued education and continued stepping forward in that spirit of my father, which was written here and not in their statutes, my own mom and dad, the ones that adopted me, told me I was a lunatic and that I needed to change the last name. Thank you for leading me in the right direction. Isaiah 43, verse 1. See, I shall subscribe in the surname of Israel from now on. You ever want me to write it down? It's going to be Israel, and it's going to be in plain block English writing, not in cursive. And if you don't like that, that's too bad. I can't give you anything else because it's not mine. If you wanted me to give you something else, it's going to be El Hotep Second We Peril. And if you can't comprehend that, that's your own incompetence, not mine. Because I will gladly see you in the international forum in front of the international people talking about the Treaty of Bern and the originator and the protections of their literary and artistic works. Because the work that you're depending upon, even in that thin blue line, is somebody else's work, not your own. See, you fall under your own fallacy by believing in the thin blue line. You fall under your own fallacy by believing in a flag.
If you can't believe in yourself and how you stand without flagging, without becoming weak and bending, then you'll never comprehend what you really do stand for. That's why I don't bend. I'm 105 pounds at this point in time. 105 pounds. I don't give a rat's ass. And it's not because I'm all weaponized. It's not because I'm such a badass person. I'm not. Record proves that, 93 cases. What proves that I'm badass is that those 93 cases, all of a sudden, now they can't put anything on the record because I said so. Why did I say so? Because I quit signing. If they don't have that signature, they can't put the document on the record and prove that it's valid in accordance in relation to my person or any person related to me in any sense, because I don't have any person. That's their fiction. And they signed it. It proves they're the ones liable. It proves they're the ones that are culpable, not me. So keep letting them enter evidence against themselves. And that's what you're doing, folks. Officers, anything you can or anything you say and do can and will be used against you in his court of law. Because I'm not going to make any judgment. That judgment comes when you pass on. I'm going to forgive you. And I'm going to hope you're going to forgive me. But in the meantime, I don't give a rat's ass again if you don't. He commanded, and it was done. He spake, and that stood fast. Anything less is a flag, and it should be a red flag. Should be a red flag telling you, stop. With that, I yield. Hope you guys enjoyed this video today. And like I said, this is a call out to everybody. It's called thinking. You should try it sometime. So no matter whether you think you know what you're doing in those courts and you're trying to profess that you have some kind of authority over another man, this video here already proves that you're full of it. You're full of it. Bring on the English majors and rebut the defendant being abstract third person noun that is nothing but a total fiction and cannot possibly volunteer itself into court. It has to be presented or represented by somebody else. And it ain't going to be me. Ain't going to be the Keith or the little faith-based union. He's a respecter of no persons. So again, have a great day, folks. Remember, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be doing this. God bless. I love you. Hit the share button, hit that like button. That'll help up all of the views. And just by the way, I want to thank everybody. I've got over 1,000 views or 1,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel. I would really appreciate it if you could help jack that up, because I'm tired of seeing people like Chili DeCastro and all these other people on there with 46,000 subscribers, and they're all listening to babble. They're all listening to babble. And I put my stuff out there on those, and nobody wants to communicate with me. You don't see them posting videos about me and my bullshit, because my shit ain't bullshit. My shit's right there in the public domain. When they want to sit there and argue back and forth about the thin blue line, one guy wants to tag delete laws about the thin blue line. Another guy wants to tag delete laws about this. Now, I'm gonna tag all of them about all of their stupidity. You want to sit there and claim that... this guy wants to talk about delete laws in his residence. Well, let's talk about the resident then, because again, that is a third person fictional noun, abstract noun that cannot be true unless you have taken an oath of office and have a license under that oath of office to prove that you are then qualified as a resident. This is what tells us you can't sue or be sued in those courts either. You have to take on the full-fledged contract of that military venue, both admiralty under oath, and commercially, maritime, under license in order to operate in the duality of those courts. Otherwise, you're the dumbass. So think about it. And remember, I'll put my PayPal button up there. Please, please, share the YouTube channel, share the likes, share the Facebook posting here, share, but please share, hit that PayPal button and share some love. In the meantime, God bless. Remember again, I love you. If it wasn't for you guys, I would not be doing that. Who's got the black and white? Yes, I love it. I see a symbol up there, somebody's profile picture, black and white, the diagonal black and white. That is it, folks. Articles 58 through 61 of the Rules of Land Warfare. You can find this in the Library of Congress. And it talks all about noting your stance and giving them notice of an armistice that they have no authority, no jurisdiction, even territorial jurisdiction. The only territorial jurisdiction they would have in any venue, when you start learning the relevance of that sign and educating people on that sign, is that they are there to protect that private territory. Again, under the Treaty of Bern and the Law of Nations. Not some local statutory municipal code or bond. I love it, brother. Whoever's posting that, keep learning, keep learning, keep sharing. And again, hit that PayPal share button. Share me some love. And God bless. I love y'all. Again, if it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't have a need to put this out. It's already posted in my site. I urge everybody to start learning how to do this. Have a good day.